Hey everyone, Stu from Body Fit Solutions. How are you doing on that? I'm just going to run through some basic exercises that's going to help you to free up a little bit of hip mobility and free up some tension maybe in your back. If you sit a lot through work, if you sit a lot to drive, or you're generally not that active and you feel that you're maybe getting some pain, some tension around the hips, the back. And it's going to free up a little bit of space in your body to therefore do better exercises and become pain free. I'm just going to need some form of padding or a cushion of some sort. And what we're going to do is place it down and straight away go into what we call a split stance. So one knee on the back pad or cushion, and we're just going to look at a nice tall line running from your knee, hip and upper torso from there. Just start with a basic rock forward and a rock back. So we're stretching now in this back leg on your hip, and we get a little bit of hamstring work on the front back of hamstring. So just a few rocks forward there. Now we need to open up the space a little bit between there. So bring the front foot a little bit wider and bring the hands down. So we're in front. So we're a little bit wider with that split stance. Relax into it. And what I'm gonna do now is just start to roll and circle through both hips. It's good because it addresses some ankle mobility as well in that front leg. And then we've got to start focusing on the breathing. So we're inhaling inside of the circle and exhale on the outside. Our hips love 3D movements, circular movements, so this is going to be really beneficial if you sit a lot through the day. Like I said, practice this regularly. Even if you can get up your seat and do it, it'd be good. Do it regularly, on the hour, every hour. Just melting into it. No major effort with this first. And change the direction. It's a different circle pattern. And if you feel you've got a little bit more to give, maybe go a little bit wider. If you've not, keep it quite close. So make it personal for you as an individual. So just gentle circles. Around about 30 seconds each way with those circles. I've got a little bit of upper spine rotation in now, so we go back more into a bit more of an inline position. Press lightly into the standing arm. I'm going to, on the inhale, I'm going to rotate my upper torso, glance up towards the ceiling, and exhale, bring it down. No major effort now, and go the other way. So just turning through the head, neck, shoulders, almost trying to keep your hips relatively still. So it's a good thoracic spine mobility exercise. If you sit at a desk using a computer, if you're holding the steering wheel repeatedly, this is going to nice free up a little bit of space in your shoulders. Okay, from there, before we go on the other leg, got a little bit of a down dog exercise. So coming into a bit of a plank position and press lightly into the floor, lift your hips up, tailbone up, and walk the hands back into this inverted V position. You probably see from my heels now, I'm going to allow one heel to sink towards the floor as the other leg flexes at the knee, and I'm going to alternate. So I'm trying to keep that tailbone up, glancing down, so keep a nice long spine, long back, and alternate. So this is great for the ankles, it's working through my calves as well. And what I love about this is it's mobile stretching, so there's nothing static about it. It's keeping moving, keeping breathing going, working through my shoulders as well to keep that nice and long line through my spine. Lift and lower, 5 to 10 each side. Rest back again, a little roll of the shoulders. We'll repeat on the other side. So opposite knee, swing the leg out in front, and just first and foremost, just come upright. See how that feels? Might feel completely different on this other side, so listen to your body and just start with a little sagittal rock forward. So the back hip is getting a bit of length, a bit of stretch, and rock back, a bit of hamstring. Bit of hip. So we're just keeping the first few in a straight pattern. Breathing as we go. Again, widen the stance. And start to floss through these hips again. So hands down. And breathing. So pick a direction. Just smoothly start to flow through that. So half a circle inhale, half a circle exhale. And it's really just free up space in the joints. It'll help your squat. It'll help you to lunge. So whether you be a sports person or you're just generally looking at exercise to lose weight and get fitter, it's a win-win. Good, change the direction. Consistency is key when it comes to this. So if feel like you're running, it's a good thing to do before your runs, after the runs. Already freeing up a bit of space in my joints there, so I feel like it's a little bit easier. Not overworking it. Okay, that thoracic spine now. So press lightly into the arm. That arm slightly spirals in, so I'm connecting in to my lats now and inhale to reach up. Exhale down. Again, not forcing it. Just going with what your body's got to give at that time. And when done repeatedly, 3 to 5 times a week, it'll help build a strong foundation from having that mobility in your body. If you feel a little bit more restricted on one side, I propose you spend a little bit longer to address any asymmetry. So I'm a little bit tight on this side, so I'm just going to do one more each side. Trying to keep stable in my hips and rotate and reach through my upper back. Rest down, both knees back on the pad, and just a little bit of a shell stretch to release. Crawl hands forward. Take a few deep breaths there. Free your hips. Better rotation through my spine now. Get on it. Get on it regularly, and you'll see a difference in your workouts. Thanks a lot.